Hi guys, FX GOAT. So today we're going to cover the three biggest mistakes in Forex trading. You're going to like it.
Yeah. Don't forget to smash that like button. Show some love. We appreciate it. FX GOAT, baby.
Yeah.
Hi there, FX GOAT speaking here, one of your Forex mentors, and in this lesson we'll be discussing three big mistakes to avoid in order to become a professional trader. So without any further waste of time, let's get started. So as FX GOATs, our goal is to make a difference. We're trying to change these horrible stats of 95 newbie traders failing every time when they're starting to enter into the Forex market. So basically here, we're trying to bridge the gap between retail traders and professional traders. Reason being is we've met a lot of retail traders who put in the hours, the work, but don't seem to get the results. Reason being is that they don't see which areas need improvement or where exactly they're making mistakes. I've made these step-by-step procedures to help you guys identify your mistakes and how to improve. So now let's get started. First mistake is that many traders don't understand why losses are important. Every professional trader has a system. The system comes with a series of consecutive losses that are within it. Meaning, having a trading system, you get to actually learn how to apply discipline. Because forex trading, you always have wins and you always have losses. But it doesn't matter how many times you win or how many times you lose. What matters is in forex trading, how much do you win when you are right and how much do you lose when you are wrong. So that's basically what you need to learn first in order for you to master forex trading. So many people always lose because they're trying to avoid losses. You can't have a system without losses, meaning you must be able to make losses and learn from your mistakes. Because in forex trading, we understand failure is part of success. Let me give you an example. I wouldn't have been a professional trader if it wasn't for my losses. What I got to understand was that we lose, we learn. You pay a price now so that you're wiser than yesterday. So basically, if you forget your past, you're condemned to repeat it. What I did for me to improve my trading was that I started having a trading journal. Having a trading journal helped me to stop making the same mistakes over and over again. I was able to identify which areas need improvement and which areas was lagging off. So I got to see which mistakes I was repeating over and over and then actually spot them out. That's how I improved trading. So basically now, I want you to understand that early stages of forex trading are basically for learning. And then do not want to skip the learning curve. Okay, let's go to the next slide. Trading styles. There's different trading styles. Your method of trading has to suit your personality. Because what you're going to discover as a new trader is that to be a good trader, you need to be good at life. Anything you like as a person will need to be addressed in your journey in order to become a successful trader. So basically what I mean here is that forex trading, like I said before, is a business. And then every time your business grows, you need to grow as well. And then anything you lack in personally, it will also be reflected in your trading journey. Here's the stages that you need to go through in order for you to have a successful trading journey. Stages you can skip in your journey. The first stage being the losing stage. This stage, I usually call it the reshuffling stage. So in this stage, you get to understand that you can lose consistently, so and then you shouldn't personalize your losses. Every time you lose, you must always take that loss as a lesson. Every loss, you must write down and see where you made a mistake and basically try to find areas of improvement. And then immediately, when you pass this first stage, you'll now enter into the second stage, which is the winning stage. Now, when you enter into this winning stage, you can have a continuous winning streak. And then this stage will make you think that you now understand the market. You basically think that you control the market, and immediately when you start losing from this stage, that's when now you need to go back to your drawing board. That will lead you to the last stage, which is the break-even stage. Now in this last stage, which is the break-even stage, you now understand that wins and losses are part of forex trading. Then now you need to understand now how much is your winning system. So basically what I mean is that you need to now discover your winning and your losing rate. How much do you win when you're right, and then how much do you lose when you're wrong? It's the first stage into becoming a professional trader. So that's basically what we add now. Hence, we're building our accuracy rate from 90% to 95%, meaning we still understand that 10% and 5% are still a capability of us making losses. Hence, we understand it's forex trading. You win some, you lose some. So now, I want you to learn from every trade. Have every thought about every trade you take, and then learn from it. It doesn't matter that it was a loss. It doesn't matter if it was a win. Every trade that you take must always be a lesson. Okay, so now let's go to the last slide. which is the support group. The reason I'm saying is because I've noticed that a lot of retail traders like to trade individually. That's exactly where they have it wrong. That's a very big mistake. Why? Because you need to have a trading support group, because every professional trader knows that it's better to have more than just one perspective regarding the markets. That's what makes the banks win. What the banks have over retail traders is that they get to trade in pairs, they get to trade in supportive groups, and that's how they can actually have more than just one perspective regarding forex trading. So now, basically, they understand that forex trading is designed to divide and conquer retail traders. So we're trying to bridge this gap by actually forming forex support groups. So for those who have enrolled under our online academy, such well-structured groups allow you to grow, provided that you're willing to participate and assist one another like the banks do. So basically, having a forex group teaches you how to remain honest. Like, they keep you on your toes, they can teach you how to actually follow procedure, how to be disciplined, how you can actually follow a trading plan over and over again. You should make sure that the forex group that you get shouldn't be people who have high egos that run you down, like who's the better trader, who knows more forex trading. That should basically help you to express what you don't understand, you know, tell them which area needs improvements, basically things like that. And then last thing I want to say is that forex trading is an unending journey. You know, we are all teachers as similarly as we're all learners. And that's all from me, FX GOAT, signing out.